So which brings us to another important question. Again, you work with a lot of different directors, from Kundan Shah to Janu Barwa's couple of films you've done. You've done almost all of Vidhu Vinod Chopra's films. You've worked with Sanjay Leela Bhansali. You've worked with Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra on multiple films. How do you adapt to the working styles of different directors? And how different is it working with, you know, each of them?
There'll be a little difference when you're working with different people, of course. Some may shout a lot in the set, some may not shout at all, some whose voice you may not hear only. But besides that, they're always interacting with the cinematographer, in a very creative fashion. So I don't think there is any room for anybody's attitude to come in over there. If an attitude comes, that means then the job doesn't turn out too good. And the only way to deal with any with a variety of directors is, I suppose, staying as a cinematographer. You know, just do your job. Besides that, if you have friends, you can have a beer after the shoot or not. That's a different thing. But during the shoot, you're professional. You work as a professional. And I don't think I've had any attitude, any problem with directors as such. I can't remember. And nobody said I will not talk to you on the.
No, what I also meant was that there are probably filmmakers or directors who are very clear about the kind of, you know, shots they want, the frames they want, and how they want it. And there might be other directors who would, you know, let you kind of, you know, decide while working with the actors, or, you know, getting the performances out. So in terms of that difference, how do you handle that?
So I think I've been very lucky to not get directors who are too hard on what type of visuals they want. So far I have not come across any director like that. And if I do come across a director like that, I think what will happen is my mind will shut down. Because now every time I'm looking at what he wants, I can frame a close-up as good as anybody else, and anybody can frame a close-up as good as anybody else. Or a long shot or whatever. Sometimes they might say, okay, what do you think about this? Yeah, that's a different thing. But if you start dictating all the things that you want to a DOP, then you might as well get an operator, no, just to operate the camera. You don't need anybody. And you get, I've seen some directors who at Filmmakers, who started operating their own cameras. Well, I'm nothing wrong with that. But then you don't get a cinematographer there. You get you take a lighting assistant. You can take my lighting assistant, like what Gopal says. Take your lighting assistant and then shoot. That's fair enough. But if you want to dictate everything to a certain extent that you want to stifle the cinematographer, then I pity the cinematographer. My mind won't be able to function.
Right. I mean, lately there has been a lot of talk of you know, the evolution of digital. Certainly the biggest area of work that has been impacted has been the DOP's work. And you've obviously seen, you know, multiple changes over the years from 75 onwards. It's almost now 40 years. How is the role of a cinematographer, you know, changed in the digital filmmaking?
Digital photography has permitted the cinematographer to go a little more on the edge. You can take more risks. By that, I don't mean to say you can light up badly and get away with it. You can get away with it, but that's not the ideal scenario. The ideal scenario is when you wanted to go a step further, but you are trying to play safe in film. Now you don't have to do that. There are other problems, like everybody is looking at what you've done, and anybody can comment, "Arey, wo to aisa ho gaya," bolke. That's the negative part, because everyone can comment on what you've done. But besides that, I think it's liberated the DOP a little more. And there's also, besides seeing what you're doing, you can also do a lot more in the lab when you're processing whatever you've shot into a print. When you're doing that, there's so much you can do more. There's so much more you can do now because of the way things are handled in the computers. You can see a telephone pole, you can just you take out a telephone pole, wipe out the telephone pole if you don't need it, or if you want to add beauty to the girl, you can add more beauty to the girl, you can do more color changes now, which was just not possible when you're shooting a film. Whatever you've done is that it. That's it. Mm. The only thing you can do is now make a normal print out of it. And the only thing you can do over there is, can you make it darker, more or brighter? And what color do you want it to go towards? Do you want it a little more orange, or do you want it a little blue, or do you want it a little more green? That's the only thing you can do. Now you can say, okay, I want that blue change to a little different blue, or you can, I want that orange to look more reddish or more yellowish. Or you can say, okay, this one I want a higher contrast, so that the shadows look darker and the highlights look more brighter. Many, many more things that you can do now, which were not there before.
So has that diminished the role of a DOP? Because what can be done in the post now?
Yeah, I would consider it as an additional palette. I would not say it has diminished the role of a DOP. In fact, now I'm spending more time after shooting. Number of days I'm shooting, I'm doing for a film, now has increased. Shooting days, now I'm spending much more time in the lab. Pehle lab mein si, except for Devdas, took a lot of time in the lab, even though it was not a digital correction.
Right.
But lab mein normally you finish it in about, the main correction you finish in about 4-5 days. After that, you see, do 2-3 more corrections. So within 20 days or so maximum, you're finished. 20 days mein nahi lagta hoga. But now, thoda ye karo, thoda wo karo, and just keep on doing it.
So coming to films, what other cinematographers, you think are doing a great job, or cinematographers that you, whose work you have kind of enjoyed a lot, maybe older, maybe your contemporaries, maybe the younger lot. So who are the cinematographers that you kind of look up to or looked up to when you were studying and when you were young?
When I was studying, see, there's a lot of foreign films that you see. But besides the foreign DOPs, the one I really liked was Subrata Mitra, who shot for most of Ray's films.
Ray's.
Yeah. He was a fantastic guy. Mm-hmm. And at that time, to give such quality was an immense thing. Very well done. I really looked up to him, I really respect him as a cinematographer. Of the present lot, there are quite a few good DOPs right now, yeah. Anil Mehta is one, and there's Ravi K. Chandran. Even Ravi Varman right now is doing some very good work. I don't know too much about the other people because I don't see too many films. So that makes a little bit of a problem for me to comment, and probably it's a blessing in disguise. तो बोले क्या मेरा नाम नहीं लिया उसने
but are there any films in recent times that you've seen that you felt where cinematography was very good or amazing?
Yeah, I saw Ravi Varman's क्या है forget name ना क्या था ये रणबीर कपूर का क्या था ये दार्जिलिंग में शूट किया
बर्फी
I saw Barfi and I was totally floored with the work that Ravi had done over there, Ravi Varman. Really, very, really very nice. Unfortunately, I haven't seen too many of his other films, I just saw Ram Leela. But Barfi, I thought was outstanding in the shot. Then there's K. Ravi Chandran, who is constantly doing good work. And when I saw his Black, that's the time I really started following his work. I'm saying, wow, this guy is really good. And Anil Mehta has consistently been doing good work all the time. He's a very, very, very good cinematographer. Baki ka, I'm sorry, I don't know. I know there are a lot more others, especially from the new lot.
Mm-hmm.
There are quite a few, but I really haven't seen the films.
Fine. So is there like an old boys club in cinematographers you kind of get along? Have a drink from time to time.
Why are you saying old boys? No, unfortunately, we don't have a cinematographers group. Yeah. I have a few friends, and whatever friends I have in Bombay, they are cinematographers mostly. and we meet from time to time, but it's not a like a club sort of a feel.
Again, I think that's coming from the evolution of the digital workflow with, you know, digital filmmaking.
Mm.
How has the interaction with editors changed now, or, you know, it's evolved in the digital filmmaking space, given that, you know, there's a lot more probably involvement of the editor also in the final thing. With digital filmmaking, has the interaction of a DOP with the editor evolved? Has there been a change in that relationship between the DOP and the editor?
I don't think so. I don't know. It's the same. I can't think of any difference. No, not really.
Fine.
No, sometimes, but वो तो उस पहले ही वही हो गया. नहीं, what can be the difference? I can't figure. क्या है, you tell me?
No, I was coming from the same. You know, the whole the editor is not involved in the color grading and.
No, not at all. No. Their workflow has changed a lot.
Right.
Yeah. But not the interaction with the DOP, you know.
Right.